You have been exposed to an overview of Git and why you should consider using it. We now need to explore how do we create a project and how do we store all of those files in a Git repository. In this video, we'll revisit the idea of a repository. We'll also learn some basic bash commands as well as Git commands to use on the command line. We'll do this so we can explore how Git works using the Git workflow and the three-state model. Let's get started. In the last video, I used a folder to represent a Git repository. Remember, a Git repository is like a folder in that it stores files. And just so you know, the proper terminology for a folder when you're on the command line is a directory, so you will hear me say that often. What makes a Git repository special is that it stores snapshots of all of your project files at a point in time. So let's start with a clean slate. I first need to create a project directory. I can do that with the bash command mkdir, which stands for make directory, followed by the name of my directory, which in this instance I will call my project. I need to travel into this directory by using the command cd, which stands for change directory. Now that I have this directory, let me see if there are any files in the my project directory by using the bash command ls, which stands for list. Nothing seems to happen. This means that there are no files in my directory, which I expect. Now I need to create a Git directory that will manage the history of all the future documents I add to my project. I can do this by using the git command init for initialize git. Let's see if the git directory was created by using the ls command again. You notice that there doesn't seem to be anything in the my project directory. No worries, the git directory is actually a hidden file. If we use the ls-a bash command, we'll see everything in my directory, including everything that is hidden. You'll notice a couple things: a dot, a double dot, and a dot git directory. Do not worry about the dot and the double dot, they are created within every directory, but notice that git init did in fact work in creating my dot git directory. This will store all of my snapshots for every change I want to take a snapshot of in my project. If you would like, you can actually move into the .git directory by using the bash command cd. We can type cd.git and then use ls to see what is inside .git. You'll notice some files and directories, which you do not have to worry about at all. Within this directory is where all the magic happens. Git will manage all of your snapshots with this directory. Now, if we want to exit this directory and go back to the root of the my project directory, you can use the cd command again with a double dot. The first dot represents this directory and the second dot represents the previous directory, which allows you to move one directory back from this one. Now that I'm in the root directory of my project, I want you to understand that Git works with three different states. There's the working directory, the staging area, and the local repository. Currently in the flow of our project, we are in the working directory state. This means that we are in a state where we can make changes to files and directories, and Git will be aware of these changes. Let me demonstrate this. Let's create a file called readme.md, which is a markdown file that you'll see in most repositories. Readmes usually explain what is and how to use the repository's code. In order to create this file, we will use the bash command touch. So touch readme.md. If we type in ls, we'll notice that readme.md is in our project in the working directory state. Notice how I didn't say readme.md is in our repository. More on how to get files in your repository later. Now let's use a new git command, status, which will tell us what is going on in our working directory state. You'll see a good amount of information here, but I want you to notice is the text that says untracked files. Currently, readme.md is considered an untracked file in our working directory. What does that mean, you might ask? Well, this means that Git is aware that the readme.md file has been created because it has no history of this file being in the project before. So let's actually move towards creating a history for readme.md. In order to create a snapshot of what my project directory looks like currently, with readme.md included, we need to move readme.md to a different state known as the staging area. If we move items to the staging area, we're telling Git, I want this file to be included in the next snapshot I take of my project. Essentially, I want to create a record of this file within my history for this project in the state it is currently in. Currently, readme.md is an empty document, so its current state is empty. But for the purpose of this demonstration, we want to create a record of it in this state. In order to move readme.md into the staging area, we use the git add command, so git add readme.md. If we type git status, you'll notice a change within our status. Git now knows we want to add readme.md to our repository. You should see under changes to be committed that our readme.md file is there. Now our readme.md is being tracked and ready to be added into our repository in its current state. The last state is the local repository, which represents where our snapshots are stored as a history of our project. Now we received a hint from our previous git status when the output says changes to be committed. In order to take a snapshot of our readme.md, we need to commit it into our repository. And if you haven't guessed already, we're using the git command commit. So git commit. But we also want to include a message of why we are taking a snapshot of readme.md. Every commit should have a message to remind yourself as well as to let others know the changes you made to the repository. In this case, I'll use -m, and my message will be add readme.md. Excellent. If I hit enter, we'll receive an output that essentially tells us that one file has been changed in the history with no new lines of code. If I check git status again, there is no longer anything in my working directory or staging area to commit to my repository. But if we use another git command, log, you'll notice that the last changes we have made are now stored in the git repository with a commit. You can think of this commit as our snapshot in git's history of the project. Notice that my name and email are there to show that I made these changes in the repository. This is why you need to set up Git to know who you are. You will also see the time and my Git message to tell me and others the changes I made in the repository. Sometimes when you have a long list of commits, or if your command line is really short, you'll need to use Q to escape from Git log. Otherwise, you can use the down arrow key to scroll all the way down to the bottom so that you can get back to the command line. We went over a lot here, but let's recap. We created a directory, and in this directory, we created a file called readme.md. We moved readme.md from the working directory state to the staging area state, and then we took a snapshot of its current state by committing it into the repository, which is our final state. If you are new to Git, no worries. We'll continue to build on this knowledge as we progress through the training, and you'll become more comfortable with the commands and logic over time.